Follow your heart!
Follow your heart! Actual tattoo somebody made.
Found this on Google Images.
Yes.
So, hey, I guess we should mention it. It's coming out, like, immediately after we finish today. We did Super Mario World highlights.
Yes, highlights of Super Mario World.
Which this is relevant to.
Yeah, I didn't really pay much thought of that to that game, but that was one of the best streams we've done.
Think so.
That was fun. Just a lot of... And, hey, we're doing Mario, so...
Yeah, we're doing Mario 64. So we'll have another highlights video when we finish this game.
Yes.
This is also after the kind of shoddy performance of last stream.
Yeah, we're having some, apparently, network issues. I don't know if it's due to Comcast or whatnot, but...
Which it very well could be. Yeah. Or it might be my computer just finally being a piece of shit after all these years.
I like to think it's Comcast. That makes something... That gives us a target to blame.
Oh, I guess you'll just have to go to one of the other cable companies. Oh, wait, there are no other cable companies.
We actually did look to see if there were any alternatives, and all we had was Comcast. That was it.
Oh, no, I did the wrong thing. I don't know, I'm not trying to do Elgato. God damn it,
Did you hit Elgato?
Yeah.
Wow.
Loading. There we go, we're good.
Cool.
And the frame drops.
Yeah.
69.
Yeah. It's within acceptable levels. Okay. So, oh, did I mention that I went to a high school which provided free MacBooks?
No.
I did. Like, the high school I went to had, like, free laptops, and they were, like, crappy Apple laptops.
Yeah.
Most people, like, used them for, I use it to look at pornography, obviously. But,
obviously.
But most people manage to get, like, an emulator of N64, an N64 emulator working on their MacBooks.
Yeah.
And, oh god, the performance was shitty.
I would imagine.
Like, we think our performance is, like, bad, but they were running at, like, single-digit frame rates. It was the slowest I've ever seen it run.
Yeah.
And you know what? You know what was amazing? They were like playing these games during class. I'm just looking, going.
CDI Mario.
Luigi, look. Oops, she made lots of spaghetti art.
Was Mario ever the Hotel Mario? Was that on the CDI?
Yeah, that was a CDI game.
Okay, I couldn't remember if Mario had actually been on the CDI or not. This is me playing, by the way. Yeah. We're trying to... This is a sense of urgency run. We're kind of sort of trying to get through this quickly.
Sense of urgency run. Alright, I guess you better unlock the cap.
Yeah.
Whee! It's beautiful, Luigi. It's full of stars.
You hated this level.
I fucking can't stand it. Yeah. The flight controls for me make no fucking sense.
I think you're just bad at them. I say as I miss a coin.
Perfect timing.
There we go. There was some, there was some heavy, like, divine retribution irony in Mario World.
Oh, yeah?
When you were the one who, started out the video saying how I was a bitch for going the normal way, and you wanted to get all the secrets and 100% everything.
Uh-huh.
And by the end of the video, you were just sick of it. You wanted to end it as soon as possible.
What was my quote? Put a bullet in its head.
Yeah, you were ending it. You were putting the bullet.
Oh, you need to do it again. The switch isn't.
That's okay. I got the secret star. If I'd hit the switch, I think it would have kicked me out of the level, but I'm not sure. I didn't want to risk it.
You can't really die in this level. You don't lose lives, so.
Aw, would have been cool.
I just got like so sick of it. It was weird how. I go from one to another, like, really quickly. One, like, opinion to another.
Bye!
Leg drop from the heavens! Hulk Hogan's... mega move.
Yeah.
I was gonna, like, limit break the leg drop from hell. brother!
So we would have streamed yesterday, but my brother's transmission broke down, and we had to spend the day in the city trying to find him a new car.
How much was would it have cost to replace the transmission?
Like $1,300, which he paid $600 for the truck.
Exactly, twice as much. So your brother was like, "Nah, I'll just get another car."
Yeah, I realize I haven't like been out for the day with him in a while though. He says brother a lot. I kept thinking of Hulk Hogan every time I was with him.
Was he saying brother in relation to you, or was he just saying brother because
brother Neil? Hero. No, he was just saying it to everyone. He was saying it to the car dealers. Yeah, brother!
Brother James, I knew you'd come! Brother Xelrog. And then what, he called me Brother Michael?
Yeah, sure. Where am I going? I need to get the 100 coins and I need to get the ring star.
Did you already get the 100 coins? No, you didn't.
No.
Alright, good. Well, bad, but...
Ah! I'm fine, I'll recover.
Brother Mario, what is it that you're doing? I'm using my body as a weapon!
Brother Mario, what are you doing, Mario?
Can you imagine Mario as a pro wrestler?
Yeah.
Like, I'm surprised. I mean, I know Microsoft did it like a pro wrestling game. It was called Pro Wrestling. They had original characters and stuff. I'm surprised they didn't do like an actual, like, super, like, Nintendo wrestling game or something.
I think that was planned at some point. Don't quote me on
planned,
that.
Planned, but not executed? I'm disappointed.
Yeah, planned, but not realized.
Like, that would be awesome!
Add that to the Mario sports family, Mario Wrestling.
Mario Wrestling. Mario and Sonic Pro Wrestling.
Well, Mario should be dead after that.
He's not dead. God. Missed opportunity. We had Punch-Out with DK, but we can't have Mario Pro Wrestling. You missed.
I told you they wanted to put Peach in Punch-Out, right?
Oh, yeah. That would have been awesome. You just Peach. It would be great if she was, like, the most difficult person to try to beat.
Yeah. I can't see where I'm going.
We live in a post-Koro world. We could have females that can kick ass and have their asses kicked in return.
Yeah. There we go.
By the way, I mentioned to you, like, a while back, but Bleach officially ended.
Oh, yeah, you mentioned this to me just the other day.
Yeah, and you were disappointed by a certain plot revelation.
Yeah, but we don't want to talk about that, because spoilers.
No. This is going to be a lot of rewrites.
Yeah. Episode 3 of Abridged. Coming. Still coming.
I'm working on the sound for that. I'm making semi-steady progress.
It's coming along.
Yes.
We're on the final act, so.
Yeah. Oh, hey, the star is there.
It
How'd
is,
How'd you get that star?
That was the fly through the 5 rings, but I need to get the 100 coins first.
Oh, yeah, you get the 100 coins without worrying about leaving the level.
Yeah.
So.
I would never leave the level before 100 item goal.
you think Mario has a reputation among like Bowser's like kingdom? Just
I think it proved he had one in Paper Mario.
Oh yeah, remember it's the legendary Mario. But that was kind of a reputation where he was like a firefighter or something. But Mario killed a lot of people.
Yeah,
he should have a John Wick reputation.
Well, they kind of did. They were afraid of him. They didn't want to fuck with Mario.
It's Mario. Oh no, we're dead men. Like a John Wick or Frank Castle reputation. Just, it's Mario. Fuck off.
I hear you hit my son. Yeah, he killed Mario's dragon.
Oh, no, he killed Mario's. He stole Mario's.
Go-kart.
What?
Go-kart.
And killed his dragon. Oh. So who would be... I guess Bowser Jr. would be the one dumb enough to do that shit.
Obviously. I could actually see that.
Mario's got two voices to me. The cartoony, it's-a me! I'm a pasta!
Yeah.
The as I call the Italia voice.
Yeah.
Or he has the Brooklyn voice. It's like American Italian voice.
Are you talking about the one that we do, the Mario 3 cartoon one?
Oh, is that his? Oh.
He actually had a different voice in the Mario Super Show. There were multiple versions. There was the Mario 3, and I think that he used the Luigi. I think he used that in Mario World cartoon too.
Oh yeah.
And then Super Show had a different cast. I don't remember what that sounded like.
Speaking of pro wrestling, there was this this thing I saw.
Yeah.
Where it was this. Not pro wrestler, he's a pro wrestling manager, Captain Lou Albano. Yeah. He was randomly wearing a Mario cap, and he said, "If you do drugs, you go to hell before you die."
Wasn't he the guy who did the swing your arms?
Maybe? I don't think so. I don't know who was in Super Mario Super Show.
I think that was Lou Albano. Albino?
I got my magical smartphone. Right, Let's take a look.
Haven't used your smartphone since Super Mario World.
No, I all right. One second. Super Mario Super Show cast. Oh yeah, the shell.
Where'd the coin go?
Yeah, it is Lou Albano.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
So it's Mario telling you, if you do drugs, you go to hell before you die.
Yeah, why else would they have had Lou Albano in the Mario getup, except that he was known for being Mario?
Captain Mario Albano. Oh man, I just like, you know how I like certain quotes that are just like, really good.
Yeah.
Like, that, and if I fuck you, I would consider it bestiality.
That was from a fanfic about Frieza and Bulma, right?
Oh yeah, Frieza's
such a condescending fuck. No pun intended.
The thing is, he actually fell through with it. He actually, like, went through with it, and then he's like, that was like a committed bestiality.
Because humans are so low in the chain compared to him.
Yeah, well, I mean, the world's strongest human couldn't make a dent in Frieza's, attack power.
He did cut off his tail, though.
True. And if he did land a direct hit, that would... an alternate universe where Krillin finished off Frieza.
Would have been great.
Oh, man. Hashtag world's strongest human.
There we go. They make it hard to get the 100 coins in this level.
Well, I mean, it's not a walk in the park, no matter where you are.
It depends. Some levels are a lot easier than others, especially with blue coins.
I guess so, yeah.
Okay, I'm going
back. I imagine it'd be easier at Thwomp's Fortress because everything's more centralized.
Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna aim for that tree. This is gonna be an ultra trick shot.
I feel like I've been in a much better mood since I started my new job.
Yeah, missed.
People at my new job like me. And so it's fine, you didn't take damage.
Mario falls out of the sky like a boss.
You know, it's a good thing you can't accidentally leave the level and render everything moot.
Yeah. Well, no, not accidentally. I was gonna say, there is a certain glitch, but you'd have to try to make that happen.
Oh.
Okay, come here, Star. I always thought that was an unnecessary maneuver to include in this game, the side jump.
Yeah, I mean, I would much rather Mario have, like, some kind of double jump. That'd be cool. Not, like, a mid-air double jump like in Banjo-Kazooie.
Oh, yeah. Was there ever a game where Mario had a double jump at base? I can't think of one.
Super Smash Brothers.
Oh, yeah, well.
But everybody did.
That's special.
What the?
Okay, so we got the first two levels done. On to water level.
Oh, my battery power's low. Water level. Oh, wait, did you finish the Thwomp's Tower Fortress?
Yes.
Okay. Alright. This is weird in this game and in no other game. Your health meter is tied to your oxygen level.
Yeah.
And then if you go into water, you can just instantly heal.
Yeah, were you talking about that in when we were playing Banjo-Kazooie? What a fuck up that was?
It's a weird oversight. I've never seen it done ever.
Yeah, I guess they were feeling
anywhere
generous.
Else. It has to be an oversight because it doesn't make any goddamn sense.
Maybe they just gave up on trying to. They just didn't think it was worth having a separate meter.
But they fixed it for Sunshine!
Eh.
Whatever.
They still had it in Mario 64 DS. They didn't, like, patch it out. It's just
Then again, that's a port. I mean, you got the source code. Oh, man, they also kept the glitches in for the Ocarina of Time source port.
Yeah, that was actually, they had patched them out, and then some of the people who were working on the game playing the original said, but those are the fun part! And so they actively decided to, you know, keep the glitches in.
Yeah, that was, I'm glad they did.
Yeah.
Well, like, the game-breaking ones you can remove, but the fun ones, the really interesting ones, you can just keep.
Yeah.
This one is a lot more chill than the flying one.
Like, what were some, what was a game-breaking glitch in Ocarina? You mean, like, the bomb to jump?
Like, something that, which either crashes the game or corrupts your save data, are ones that you can get rid of. That's game-breaking. The bomb to jump was, like, whatever.
I can't think of there being any of those in Ocarina that I remember. Except for a cartridge tilting.
Well, you can't really do that on 3DS.
No.
I mean, one thing is that you can't really plan for cartridge tilting.
No,
you can't
not
plan
really.
For some dumb motherfucker to just decide, hey, I'm gonna remove a section of the cart.
Yeah.
And see what happens.
Okay, I need to get to a certain star before I can 100 coins.
That's not really programmer error.
No. I didn't even see what star that was. Oh, the music changes when you're in the water.
Yeah, dynamic music's cool.
I think this is the sunken ship star.
I just realized something. Mario doesn't really have any combat options underwater.
No, not really.
Not many games can do, like, if you're in the water in a lot of games I've played, in my youth, you're helpless.
Yeah.
That was the same shit in Tomb Raider, because Lara Croft couldn't use guns underwater.
Whoa! What was that? That's never happened before.
Teleport! You might want to go up for air, buddy.
Yeah. Seems pragmatic. Thought I was gonna Lara Croft for a second there.
Oh my god, Lara Croft's death animations freaked the fuck out of me as a kid.
Yeah.
Just because they were just so... It's just a combination of stifled, like, groaning and just the throws, the death throws.
Yeah.
It was just like...
I wonder who voiced Lara Croft. Oh god, this. I have bad memories.
Who voiced Lara Croft in Tomb Raider 1? 1996. Oh, there's an IMDb page. Oh, shit!
Yeah, this star kind of sucks. I'm dead.
There's an oxygen you can get from up...
I don't think there is when it's at this point.
Yes, there is.
Okay, we'll go check.
There's an IMDb app?
Is there? I'm not surprised. There's an app for everything. There's an app for that!
We used to say that is a joke, but now that's kind of,
Was it a joke? It was an advertising campaign.
You've never heard of her, because I've never heard of her. Shelley Blonde.
Nope.
Of course. Yeah, you get somebody called Blonde to voice a brunette. Good job. Good job, 96. That's a game we can play, Tomb Raider.
Yeah, I have the collection on Steam. I just have never gotten around to it.
I do, too. I think it's gonna take a lot of work to, like, get running.
Yeah.
That's an old fucking game. 96.
On Steam,
They were still...
On Steam, though?
I know Good Old Games works to make sure that their games that they have are running on modern systems. Steam... kind of doesn't. If you have an old game on Steam, you just kind of have to make sure.
Hello?
You get the right... There we go. Look the opposite end. I'm pretty sure there's an air bubble. I knew it! You're not saying anything.
Well, I guess I never went up there before.
I mean, it's handy, right?
Yeah.
You sound so disappointed.
But I like being right and Jack being wrong.
Cheer up, Xelrog! Are you crying?
No.
I'm just kidding.
Hello? Bubble! damn 2D N64.
2D sprites in a 3D game. That's never gonna go out of style. Foolproof!
If you didn't turn around, you wouldn't know that the chest had reset.
Yeah, then you'd be fucked. You'd kill yourself trying to open chests. Two.
I remember this is a spiral. I just didn't ever remember the first one.
Uzumaki!
Uzumaki? Oh, it's spiral, yeah.
Yeah, there was a... No, there was a manga called Uzumaki, and it was a horror manga. And, like, it had a lot of body horror shit.
Yeah, fuck that platform!
Yeah! Oh, no! Ah, you failed!
Nah, I'm good. It was a body horror?
What?
It was a body horror?
Uzumaki, yeah. Body horror. Okay. You know what that is?
Like disfigurement?
Yes.
Because of the nine-tailed fox?
No, no, I'm talking about a different manga. Not Naruto. It's just called Uzumaki.
Oh, okay.
Okay, back to Mario.
Maruto?
Maruto.
Can the eel come out to play?
I'm a... I'm a ninja and a plumber. It actually makes sense considering ninjas are supposed to be invisible.
What were they called in the people Naruto who had the tailed things inside them? I don't remember the name for it.
Name of people who contained a tailed beast in Naruto. Jinchuriki. Jinchuriki.
You're a Jinchuriki, Mario!
You're a Jinchuriki, Harry.
You got a snake inside of you. Like a plumbing snake? No, Mario, demon snake!
It'll try to take over your body when you sleep, Mario! Meanwhile, Bowser's just looking, going, the hell's a ninja? What the fuck?
No, he hired the Ninja Koopas, remember?
Oh yeah, that's right.
What, my guys suck compared to these.
They can walk on walls? Fuck!
You jump on mine, they're helpless.
If Bowser just shows up to try to rule, like, a hidden village, he just gets ousted as a demon. I'm not a demon, I'm a Koopa, there's a difference!
He gets sealed in some kid somewhere, except Bowser inside of him.
That's a fanfic waiting to happen, Naruto, except it's Bowser instead of the QB.
He doesn't have any, like, chopper or anything to borrow. The kid just has, like, spikes on his head, that's it.
Instead of whiskers, yeah! Instead of whiskers, he just has spikes and reddish hair and greenish skin.
Come to think of it, like, grown-up Choji looked a lot like Bowser.
Grown-up Choji, human, yeah. Bowser. Did he marry, like, another chick with a wing? No, okay, he married this, like, black chick, and then they had, like, a daughter, which inherited Choji's weight.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with that. I'm just saying that was a ballsy move to make for a manga artist to go, yeah, I have a girl here that defies traditional body types. What the fuck are you gonna do about it?
Yeah, there weren't really any fat girls in Bleach, were there?
Not really, no. Like, it kind of reflects poorly on Tite Kubo.
Even in the bit characters, like Orihime's classmates.
Yeah, they were all... Well, then again, Japan doesn't really have an obesity problem. And so that's mostly an American and sometimes British thing.
Yeah, but that's not to say there are no fat people in Japan.
No, just they didn't know fat people happen to live in Karakura Town.
Oh.
They're the easiest prey for hollows, I guess. They would get the fat ones first.
So Society Television presents Fast Hollows, Slow Fat People.
Once again, a stream where we talk about everything but the game we're playing.
I was trying to stay on topic.
Ah, it's fine. It's entertainment.
So, Mario can either hold his breath either A, infinitely, or B, longer than I can.
Yeah. As long as he has coins. Coins are oxygen to Mario.
Yeah, if only Sonic could figure that out with rings.
Yeah.
No, he needs to subsist on air bubbles. Did Labyrinth terrify you as a kid, trying to play through that level?
Oh, Labyrinth Zone?
Yeah.
No. The only scary Sonic level that I found was the Pyramid one in Sonic and Knuckles.
Oh, the one with the ghosts?
Yeah. Ow.
Ow!
Not because, ghosts are scary, but because they were, unkillable, and they took up a lot of the screen and were hard to avoid in the dark.
Yeah, and you had to run from, thing to thing to pull down the chain and shit.
Yeah. There was a lot of really precise timing on that stage.
I'm surprised they didn't try to do, an open-world sandbox-type deal for Sonic games.
Oh, come on!
What the f- Mario got impaled!
They didn't quite figure out the spires for this game.
Aim higher. So, that's a question I have, is that, you think they could do a proper Sonic, free-roaming type deal?
They could, but I don't think it'd be as interesting.
Either.
What's more interesting, racing Hot Wheels on a track with loops and shit, or racing them on pavement?
I don't know, Grand Theft Auto Online's been pretty successful.
Yeah, but that has buildings and shit.
That's true.
Well, I guess, okay, it's still open world in that case. You said open world, and I immediately went to Breath of the Wild, which is very big and open.
Oh, the new Zelda game?
Yeah, that and Skyrim are kind of big open plains open world, as opposed to what GTA is with cities and shit.
Well, so, Sonic is goes through multiple terrains. You could have, there you go. Congratulations, Sonic didn't get impaled.
Sonic?
Mario.
There's nothing up here, though.
Some guy did a mod of Ocarina of Time, which replaced, Link's sprite with Sonic.
Yeah.
And had, an optional thing where you could just go fast. Sequence breaking, ahoy.
Yeah. Okay, where's the... Is the cave sealed? Can I not go...
Aw. There he is!
There it is.
Is the cave sealed?
I was gonna say, that would suck, because I'm trying to get the 100 coin star.
I guess now's the perfect time to do it.
Might as well. As long as the ship's up, you can get the red coins up there.
We floated the ship back up. Mythbusters proved that was possible.
Yeah?
They did that with ping pong balls.
So, in other words, we're saying that One Piece is realistic. With giant breath gorillas. Remember that? The salvagers?
Oh, yeah, that's right. I mean... the least, fantastic part of One Piece can be believable.
Yeah.
Every show gets one.
The least fantastic part of One Piece is that Marines are assholes.
Yeah, that's realistic. I mean... British officers in the Navy were known for being pretty fucking dickish.
Yeah.
People would rather be pirates, because at least with pirates, everything was more chill.
Yeah.
And you could split loot. People think of pirates as notorious criminals, and while that's true, there are other pirates that are basically just mercenaries.
Yeah.
Privateers, if you will. Nope. You're gonna have to go back up!
Yeah, I need one more red coin, and I know where one's at. Remember when Jack Spicer hired a shitty Blackbeard? What a travesty.
I'm gonna go back in time and hire the greatest criminals! Here, I'll hire this pirate! I'll promise him all the Spanish gold he can desire. Those of you who don't know what we're talking about, we're talking about Shaolin Showdown.
Yeah, we're...
Oh! Oh! What is it with this game and wanting Mario to be impaled?
Well, this is interesting. I'm afraid to move.
This game has some weird ass...
Do I take it out? Do I leave it in? Do I take it out? Do I leave it in?
Push it through, Mario. Can you leave? Good. Good.
Yeah, we are literally what we have a Chinese cartoons hour.
Yeah, we watched that in Jackie Chan Adventures.
Shaolin Showdown and Jackie Chan.
They're fucking hilarious shows. people who like are like, you're grown men, you're watching cartoons. I'm like, it's entertaining. We're 21 years old. We can choose what to do with our lives. We're over 21.
Yeah, I'm an animation aficionado in general. I watch everything.
Here's the thing people don't get is that you can pull off a lot more in animation than you can in live action.
Yeah, you're not bound to things having to look realistic.
Yeah, you're not bound to camera work or, you know, actors not looking quite right for the role. As long as you get the voice for it, you can just fucking, can you come out and play?
Come on. Hey, buddy.
Warriors, come out to play.
Oh, come on. Grab it.
Yeah, he got it.
There we go. Can you imagine how much unagi that would make?
Oh my god, that would feed a village.
There is you could have eel steak from that.
There was this fanfic I read for Game of Thrones, in which Tyrion Lannister doesn't get this shit into the midget, basically.
Yeah.
Doesn't get the shit into the stick. It manages to like make a mercantile republic. So he's in Westeros, he's trying to find a new place to get gold, and then they're being beset upon by krakens, or just the one kraken, and they're like, and everybody's like, oh, the gods have cursed us again. Tyrion's like, nah, fuck it, we're gonna kill it. And they do, and they're like, alright, we'll feed this to all the poor in this town. And I'm like...
Did it taste like calamari?
It was, yeah, calamari. I mean, krakens are basically giant fucking calamari.
Yeah.
You think it'd be, like, tougher, like, depending on the size of the creature?
I guess the strength. By the way, we have dropped 2,600 frames. So it's still
over the course of 30 minutes.
Yeah, still happening.
Oh, it's fine. We still got the source video. It's not like it crashed though. That was what I was concerned about.
Well, that's definitely a network issue. Is the reconnecting? But
I was gonna. I think the problem is that. Nice try. I think the problem is that just the emulator is just very.
I don't remember having it. Well. We had performance issues with Paper Mario, but we didn't have dropped frames.
Well, Paper Mario was 2D. That was a whole different game, basically, than this.
Yeah. I guess these are the only ones we played on N64. I also didn't have frame issues with Crash, though. So is that just less intense than Spyro? Spyro did come 2 years later, as I found out.
I guess so. All right. Well, we'll go with that. That makes sense. Oh, you can't use the air bubbles to recover your health here.
Yeah.
Nope. One.
I think I remember the order for this one. Once I get the first one.
And...
Huzzah!
Yay!
Don't you love treasure chest puzzles?
Treasure chest puzzles. We'll do them twice. We'll do one underwater, we'll do one on land.
At least this one wasn't underwater. The underwater one, I always remember being really tense. Just because you're losing health while simultaneously drowning.
Well, you didn't know that the health bubble was there, though.
You mean the one up high?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I always knew that was there, because I didn't expect a company like Nintendo to just throw you in the deep with 4 treasure chests, nowhere for them to go, have fun!
You didn't expect that after the NES days? remember when you had to have the specific crash weapon supply before you could get to the end of the last level in Mega Man 2? And if you didn't have it, you were fucked?
I never owned Mega Man 2 as a kid, so... No, I didn't!
Yeah.
That seriously had to happen?
Yes, you had a finite supply.
To be fair, that wasn't Nintendo, that was Capcom.
Yeah, it was Nintendo approved, though. It had the seal of approval.
The seal of approval means that there's no religious content. As long as Mega Man wasn't talking about God, they didn't give a shit.
Da-da-da-da-da, God Man!
There's like a lot of unlicensed Bible games on NES.
Yeah?
Fucking Bible Buffet!
Is that what happens after Noah's Ark?
Fuck the animals, let's just eat them.
Is there a red coin up on this? I don't think there was one up there.
There was only one for SNES. It was called Super Noah's Ark 3D.
Yeah.
It was basically Wolfenstein / Doom, except with just you're playing as Noah and you're firing berries at goats.
They fit that on SNES.
Yes. They fit Doom on SNES.
Okay. Well, I guess that's impressive.
Yeah, the sound wasn't half bad either. I mean, Nintendo has always been, like, pigeonholed as a family-friendly console, but they had violent games on their systems.
Yeah.
What with,
a varying degree.
Primal Rage, Killer Instinct.
Doom was the really standout one, but they had that Turok on N64.
Turok.
I don't know how violent Perfect Dark was.
They had Goldeneye. Goldeneye and Perfect Dark are... They use the same engine.
Or Jet Force Gemini. I remember.
Oh, that was violent. That was like insects were getting like splattered and shit.
Well, they weren't people though.
And Goldeneye had like miner blood, not. Oh man, I should play Goldeneye.
Oh, they kill miners?
Miner blood. Not
I was making a joke.
Not kids or people who like get ore from tunnels. Although there was a level that took place in mines. I think.
The fat demon in Jackie Chan had her own salt mine.
I didn't know that was where that was gonna go. I thought it was just like, oh look, the salt mines. LOL.
That was a dumb season finale, the Book of Ages. I'm sure
And they'll never use it again! Because it's a movie.
I think more people remember Jackie Chan than remember Shaolin Showdown, just because it's so quotable.
Jackie Chan, he has his name value attached to it.
Yeah, it had a lot of, it had a lot of catchphrases and it's created memes. Yes. It's more memetic.
One more thing. Well, that is really cool, good characters.
Yeah.
Even the tag-along kid character in that show was pretty useful.
Jackie Chan was the least interesting character in his own show.
You know, I think Jackie Chan would have preferred it that way.
Yeah.
Oh, Mario. So... There's not a whole lot of humans in the Mario-verse.
No,
it's just Mario, Luigi, Princess Peach, I guess Wario?
Wow.
Humans are an endangered species in the Mario-verse.
I'm gonna get a...
It's all Goombas, Koopas, and Toads.
All right, I got the captain's seat!
I don't know. I actually don't remember where the last one's at.
Last what? Red coin?
Yeah.
Isn't it, like, in a shell? Is it at the beginning of the stage?
I don't think so, but I can check. Don't look it up.
I could have been reaching for my booze. You don't know.
Oh yeah, you found some. Found
I
some
I
rum.
I thought I got rid of all my rum. I didn't. And I'm like looking at it, and I noticed it was like 50% alcohol. And I'm like,
oh wait, I remember.
Fuck it, I'll drink it. So
I think this coin's sitting on a little shelf like these, and it's annoyingly out of the way. Maybe it's in here. Yep.
You did it! Congratulations! Water levels are always boring to me.
It's very slow moving. And it's not fun to be slow in a video game.
No, you want to go fast. That's why Sonic's popular!
Yeah. It's not because of his personality, I'll tell you that.
Radical!
Where's Nasty Nork? I want to torch him!
I'd rather hang out with Sonic than I will with Spiral, I'll tell you what.
Yeah.
Red coins on the ship afloat. Now we'll see what else is on this boat.
Yarr! Through the jet stream. Oh, I need to be metal for this one.
No, you can't do this level. Not yet. You're gonna have to fuck off.
Okay, I remember, you have to be not moving in order to exit course in this game.
Yes. They don't want you to, like, fall, and then, oh, I'm gonna jet out of this level to save lives.
Yeah. You know, it's better than water levels. Ice levels! That's okay. This is actually, as a rule, I hate all ice levels in video games, but this is actually one of the enjoyable ones.
I declare blood feud on all ice levels in video games.
Mario's off in Star World while Luigi has to scale Ice Mountain.
How you left me to deal with the fucking ice levels? That was nasty. Hey, look, penguins.
Okay, do I have to?
This is the game where they decided, you know what? Let's have penguins be a race in Mario games.
Yeah. Ow.
So you got four humans, Goombas, which
for all we know, Toads might be like half humans,
half human, half fungi.
Yeah, sure. I don't remember how difficult 100 coins is in this level.
I can't imagine it's all that easy.
There's lots of sliding. Indoor and outdoor slides.
Declare blood feud on all ice levels.
They realize that, you know, people really hate the slip-sliding mechanics in, like, Mario 3 and Mario World ice levels. Can we make sliding fun? And so that's
they had a good effort! I mean...
No, I love the slides in this game.
Yeah, I don't like having to, okay, this level isn't too bad when it comes to platforming. There aren't any, like, you know...
What a shitty blue coin switch.
You gained 10 coins, congratulations! Also, you can head up the slides pretty okay, I guess.
Up to a point. There are some areas that are too steep.
Mario's personality has always been very ill-defined.
Well, he's just... That's why I mentioned earlier that there are two types of main characters. There's the... As far as, you know, kid-friendly platforming games go, is that there's the idiot main characters like Crash, and there's the radical main characters.
The edgy
like,
main character.
Like Sonic and Spyro.
Yes.
And Banjo's the idiot kind, and honestly, yeah. I think Mario's the idiot kind too, because he doesn't speak English. He talks in catchphrases.
he talks in memes.
I doubt he's literate.
He can read signs. Luigi's the only one who can talk!
Yeah.
Oh no!
Ravioli. Spaghetti.
Hey, Germany!
Pizza!
I made a white flag for you. We can wave it together.
Mario is literally Italy from Italia.
It would be amazing if Mario made a cameo in Italia. I don't think he ever does.
What would Bowser Beach then?
I don't know. Germany?
Germany.
He's got that kind of military mindset,
I guess.
We will not tolerate weakness in the Koopa Army!
Gosh. It's a good thing they just didn't make Germany in that show an out and out Nazi.
Yeah.
They just happened to have him like, this Nazism is coming into power! Blood feud on all Nazis forever, right?
Yeah.
Good. There's a reason why you can use... If you don't have a decent antagonist in a game, you just make him a Nazi.
Yeah.
That's all the reason you need to kill him.
What was it in South Park? They were Nazi zombie somethings?
Nazi zombie... jihadists.
I don't remember. I think they were just Nazi zombies.
So, it's a zombie that happens to wear like a Nazi uniform and a turban.
I guess.
The most hated like antagonist.
But he's also Russian.
No, Russians
are. Are we past that? Are they no longer the bad guys and things?
No, they're okay.
What about John Wick?
Well, that was different. He didn't declare a blood feud on all Russians. He just declared a blood feud on all Russians that happen to serve this one guy's father's son.
Just that Russian mafia.
Yeah.
Oh, there's no no penguin, so I guess I'm on my own for this slide.
Whee!
Wow, it would suck if I died here after collecting all those coins.
Evening, Mario! Evening, Toad. Noise complaint. Noise complaint. Sees a bunch of shells overturned. You working again? No, I just did some stuff I'm gonna check it out. Okay, I'll leave you be then, Mario.
Okay!
You know, that actually makes sense, because in John Wick, they also use gold coins.
God, I hate having that guy around.
You did it!
Where else is there? I don't remember. No, the igloo's not on this level. It's on a different level.
Yeah.
I was trying to remember if there was a, like an extra area on this one, but it's just the slide.
They don't have less than 100 coins in,
God, this is gonna suck. What? If I get the 100 coins on the slide. I just realized.
Oh no,
this.
Don't do it!
There's nowhere else there are coins left.
Oh, you're fucked then. You're fucked.
I can do it.
Okay, next time, do the slide first.
Yeah, that would have been wise.
Yes. Yeah, good luck with that cornering, bro. 88! Oh, no! 95! Jump!
Jumping.
You jumping. Did it!
Yay! And now he's no problem standing.
Oh!
Mamma mia!
You gotta get the other star. Don't die just yet, bro.
See, it's too easy to do the regular Mario voice. That's why the cartoon one is more fun.
Luigi! Evening, Toad!
We're plumbers, Luigi. We're paid to clean things out.
His brother dies of Terminal 7 cancer.
And it gives him a pet
Yoshi.
Yeah. God damn it. Okay, he did not slide this much in the original. I think this ROM has added difficulty because...
What? You think some guy just took a ROM and just decided to make it randomly more difficult?
I think the emulator is not processing things quite right.
It's fine. It's not the... This is the worst when you're having problems with an emulator. At least it's not Paper Mario.
Yeah, that would have sucked.
Little Penguin lost. Something I hold against this game that I don't hold against Banjo-Kazooie is that in this game, when you get a collect a star, you have to go back out. Whereas in Banjo-Kazooie, like, you can collect a Jiggy and still be fine. And just still continue the level.
I guess I can't teleport with this guy. Oh well.
You didn't think it'd be that easy, did you?
Whee! Who needs regular slides?
Oh, you're going. Were you down here before?
Nope.
Or during the... You could have gone down here. Oh well.
I just jumped down the level.
Scaling a cliff.
After a harrowing adventure, I found your child.
Mario Wick. Hey, Mario! I'm not gonna be around for very much longer, so I gave you this Yoshi so you can feel better! And he's just like... sad. That's not my baby!
Looks nothing like me!
You sure about that, bro?
She takes it anyway. Fine.
Oh.
How did it get up there? That's an adventurous baby.
Maybe the mother just forgot it and just thought, oh.
Wandered into the warp.
Yeah, you wander into the warp, you're not coming out the same way.
Alright, penguin race. The 100 coin stars are the only ones that usually take a lot of time, too.
Well, because you gotta hunt down like 100 coins, and that's not really fun. Mario's a man of commitment. Something you know very little about. I once saw him kill 5 Koopas by jumping. By fucking jumping!
He didn't throw a punch or anything.
I don't remember. Whoa, guys!
Oh, shit!
I don't remember what kind of cheating is allowed.
Good luck.
I think if you do what I just did, he'll call you out for cheating, but not if you take the wall shortcut.
I think I remember the opposite. You can do that just fine, but yeah. You can't take the shortcut.
That might be.
Either way, this will be over quickly, so it's not like we're losing too much time. Yeah, reverse butt slide.
Uh-oh, I'm on my belly now.
That was faster.
Is it?
Yeah. You don't turn very well, but you're fast.
Okay, I was not aware of that.
Oh no!
Fuck you, penguin!
How is it so fast?!
Oh. Well, at least I didn't die. Is he mad? Hello, having fun with your friend? I am!
Yeah, my friend. Thank you for calling us friends. I know I don't come off about it because I don't come off as his friend because I get so angry sometimes, but I don't legitimately get, like, angry at him. That came out wrong.
Once more.
We will beat the penguin.
I wonder what a penguin tastes like.
I wouldn't think of eating it, you psycho.
Hey, it's a bird. Might taste like chicken.
Probably tastes like a bird, then.
Maybe it tastes like a combination of like, poultry and fish.
How does it taste? Snake, you want to eat a penguin?
I've eaten worse things.
There, in that game... Oh! I saw
that. I know I can make it. I'm gonna try that.
The ultimate in cheating.
I don't go down any length of the track. I just jump twice.
Mario, I challenge you to a Shaolin showdown.
Well, I'm here to help because I've played this game and beaten it.
So have we.
That's very impressive. I don't think many people in history have beaten this game. I'm sorry, that was uncalled for sarcasm.
Also here to watch. Can you do it?
Come here!
Oh, shit! You can make- Oh! Nah, just under.
Too far. I gotta curve it like Spyro.
Spyro has a turning radius. Mario doesn't have a fucking turning radius. He can turn on a dime.
Well, he can 180 on a dime. He has a turning radius in the air. That's why you hate the air.
Mario is skilled in parkour.
I'm committed to doing it this way.
I know you are. He can stop in midair just by rotating his body a certain way.
Okay, I actually want to make a Oh!
You did it! Oh!
Well, that was a little anticlimactic. Your shortcuts count as cheating. I don't know. We have yet to find this out. We know there's one way you can get away with it, and there's one way that'll call you out for cheating. I don't remember which is which. There we go.
Yeah, this rum's really strong. The taste. You did it!
Come on!
Go!
Come on, Mario.
Go!
Come
on. Go! He broke his spine!
That's okay, coins helped him. Coins are healing. It's just like real life. If you have enough money, you can heal from anything.
Alright, what's he say? Oh, he's yep.
Aww.
You gotta do it the normal way.
Okay.
Okay, Penguin, I'm sorry.
I can swear that there's one of them that's,
the wall.
Okay, yeah, I'll try the wall.
Yeah, he's saying the wall, and it matches up, so. So, no, that's an insane just shortcut.
Just like Koopa the Quick, you gotta cheat him the right way.
You can use the warps, but you can't use the cannon.
Yeah.
Because he sees that.
Obviously.
And the what?
And the slide.
We are sliding. I want a good clean fight. Don't try to shortcut through the track.
You see that episode of South Park where Cartman takes on the what's the word? Remediary class?
The remediary, what?
The bunch of, like, ghetto kids who are failing in school.
Oh, does he actually do that?
Yeah, and he teaches them all how to cheat.
Oh!
And they become, like, the highest test scoring class in the
nation. Oh, what?
Okay, I guess they both count as cheating.
Well, I guess they're gonna have
okay,
to
I guess
do it
I missed
legitimately.
Oh, well. We tried.
Just don't use shortcuts. We saw that note too late.
Oh, but it was fun to try. I discovered a new one. With the double jump.
That is like, that's a cliche now, right? The whole concept of, oh, these inner city school kids are failing. We're gonna send somebody to help them out.
Yeah.
We just need the right teacher.
We need Dr. Phil.
You gotta grow up!
Oh, the coins are still gone.
You know, Dr. Phil played himself in a scary movie sequel?
Did he?
Yeah, it was weird. He basically played a caricature of himself.
Maybe he was interested in how the film would affect, like, young people's psychology?
No, he wasn't interested. He was just basically saying... He was making fun of himself.
Yeah.
You did it.
Did it the boring, normal way. And you're more impressed than when I came up with creative ways to beat you.
Like, just... There you go. Backseat gaming. I do it all the time. You're allowed to as well. So every 50 coins is an extra life in this game, huh?
Is it?
Yeah, it seems like it.
Frosty slide for 8 red coins.
So just get 8 red coins.
Yeah. Abundant lives. Ow. This is a random ice pillar.
What hotel would Mario go to in Mario Wick? Like okay, we got the Continental in John Wick universe, but what would be the equivalent of that? Hotel Mario? No. Princess Peach's castle.
Yeah, sure. Uh oh. Okay.
You know the rules. No business is to be conducted in Princess Peach's castle.
Luigi's mansion.
Luigi's mansion.
Or just a toad house.
Little Luigi's dead. He doesn't have a mansion anymore.
Yeah.
Hell is alive.
Just with the toad house in.
Okay, yeah. The toad is just like, Mario! I don't want to do the voice! Fuck!
Infernal wailing. I have something infernal to tell you about, but I think it needs to wait until our next After Dark stream.
Oh. Oh, when we get started on a quest of monsters?
Yes.
Not for Twitch, sadly.
No. We'll see how, well. Do we want to see how this video turns out in, like, post, or...?
It should be fine in post. I mean, I always imagine that the recording is like,
we
okay.
Had the, we
no,
had...
the only time it really drops frames is when you're transmitting.
We had the, like, stuttering issues in the YouTube videos for Banjo and Spyro.
Oh, did we?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
I feel like I'm missing one.
A combined total of 4% of the video is lost forever, apparently.
Well, I don't know if that, that accounts for that or not. Is there one on that island out there?
Our good viewer is listing all of them.
Listing all of what? The coins?
The coins we didn't get.
Oh, fuck, I'm...
No!
Well, that's so much for that.
Oh, you're... No! You fool.
I slipped.
You ever watch Gremlins?
No.
It's another really good Christmas movie. It's a Christmas movie in which, during a lull in the Gremlins' havoc, this love interest is talking to the main character and the cute critter Gizmo, and he's like saying this story about there was one day during like Christmas Eve, and we were waiting for our dad to come home, and he was missing. And then Christmas came and went, and he just wasn't there. Our family was just, or we called the cops, and just weren't able to find him. And then one day we were trying to light a fire in the fireplace, and then we noticed a smell. And then we looked, and we saw it was our father with his arm dressed as Santa Claus, with his arms filled with presents. And that's when I just knew there wasn't a Santa Claus. This is a kids' movie, by the way.
Yeah.
it's like that was like the entirety of One Magic Christmas.
Yeah. Was that, what, do you consider that a dark movie?
What, One Magic Christmas or yeah. Gremlins?
The One Magic Christmas.
I mean, it had Santa Claus as a necromancer.
Was he?
He had like the souls of the dead working for him with his workshop.
Did he?
Yeah.
I remember very little of that movie.
I forced you to watch it at something point.
Yeah.
Porn point?
No.
No? Okay, yeah, that makes sense. And then it was like that one that everybody's like, where's your Christmas spirit at? And then we were joking, oh, I'm Jewish.
And then Santa just stared at her. Come on, Mario, you can make it, you fat ass.
He's heavy. Those trucks slide really hardcore on snowy roads.
Yeah.
Leap! Use your B to leap, like. Just,
I tried.
Z jump?
I'm trying. Okay, what, that worked. I still think there's additional sliding because of this emulator, so I want to be wary with my platform.
Yeah, emulation, it increases difficulty.
Hello, snowman. Will you be my
friend?
Don't
fire! Mercy! What kind of a snowman has a flower growing out of its head? That's an abomination. Kill
them
all.
Is that one supposed to be a snowman?
What is it supposed to be if not a snowman?
I don't know, just a flower head thing? I don't care about your baby!
Flower head.
Bowser came and took my baby!
Sir, we found this corpse. You should see it. It's just a picture of a corpse with flowers growing out of it. It's like, Flowerhead. I knew you'd come back.
I mean, we already
had... Get the weed killer.
We already had Tomato Head. The Urus Idiots are a horror parody.
Oh, yeah. Who burned down the tomato shack?
The baby.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Charrington is a good
Can you imagine how this conversation sounds out of context? A baby dirt burned down a tomato shack, resulting in a tomato serial killer.
It's just two people, they're both having a stream of consciousness discussion.
Oh, come on. Gotta do this shit again. Hello, snowman friend.
Can't wait to get another job so I can afford weed again.
There weren't any snowmen and enemies in Undertale, were there?
Well, there was a snowman, but he wasn't an enemy.
Yeah. Was anyone really an enemy?
People who are trying to kill you, yeah. They're enemies. Hey, he's hosting us.
Thank you for that.
Thank you. We can go for another hour.
Yeah, we could. Dropped frames 5,500. It's still doing little bits.
Little bits. It's mildly annoying. I don't think it's enough to cause any real issues. It only seems to be when the emulator's, like, loading things.
By the end of the top half of the slide. He's suggesting a method for, like, cheaping the way to the sixth star. I'll try it.
Alright. Oh, here?
Oh, okay, I see it.
Alright, you know what to do now.
Obviously.
It only took us sacrificing one life. So, 1-Up Shrooms are apparently the most valuable shrooms in Mario Land because they can stave off death.
Well, in this case, I guess what would be... I guess Ultra Shroom versus Life Shroom in Paper Mario. They're both pretty valuable.
Yeah. Not there.
What's there? Isn't that it?
The bottom where Mario can stand.
Is that another place?
The bottom where Mario can stand is where he says, but...
Oh no, this is the regular. Okay, the... I thought you said the end of the first half of the slide, though, so I just assumed the turnaround there.
That's fine. It's not about the ending, it's about the journey.
Okay. The journey of 1,000 miles.
Whee!
Ow.
Ow.
And that was the day Christmas was ruined for Mario. Shortcut.
He's saying some more stuff.
Ending of the slide. Well, this is the ending of the slide, and I'm guessing it's under there. Oh, I see it.
Oh. It's a good thing Mario has the ability to kind of change his direction midair.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's a lot of people in, Yeah, I see what you're trying to do. I'm sure there's a lot of people in real life that would love to have that.
Yeah? Just that kind of third-person viewing ability?
Well, not just that, but just the ability to change your direction mid-air. It was like you're falling and you're about to hit something, so you just kind of maneuver yourself out of the way mid-air.
That'd be cool. I don't know how often that happens to people, but...
I don't know! I've seen a lot of YouTube videos of people doing crazy shit,
Depends on your profession, I guess.
You know, like a dirt bike rider, that'd be so useful.
Get up, Mario. Goddamn extra sliding. Okay, what's gonna be the best spot for this? It looks like it's the closest to that area there. Uh-oh, I am buffering. That's bad for you, viewer. Sorry about that.
Buffering? Oh no.
Oh! Almost.
You almost had it!
That was a little late.
It's okay, you got a lot of lives.
Plenty of lives. All the Marios. What if it's like a 100 Mario mode in Mario Maker, and these are all just like individual Marios, an army of Marios?
That's how it was like originally.
Maybe that's why Peach has never gotten into a relationship with him. There's not just one of them. It wouldn't be fair to the others.
Mario, that's the secret of Mario, he clones himself.
Maybe that's what 1-Up Shrooms are, they're cloning technology.
Cloning shrooms, you eat it, and then you just produce a second Mario?
Yeah, it's like that spell that Jade did in Jackie Chan.
Reminds me of this Flash game called Enough Clones. It had this Mario-like character, and every time you picked up a coin, there was another Mario. Like, literally, right then and there. And at least one Mario had to get to the end.
Yeah. When it doesn't have a slanted edge. You're talking about here?
Telephone in real life.
Yeah,
you fucked yourself. You knocked yourself unconscious.
I feel like I was closer the last time.
Trial and error, man. It's not like you're gonna lose some of your stars if you lose lives.
Yeah.
No falling damage in snow.
Nope.
It's soft.
I'm gonna try this method again. Fuck. Not the best angle they're giving me though.
Yeah.
Oh.
That's not gonna work.
Yeah,
I think you're gonna have to go to the other corner. Like
the top of it?
No, to like 90 degrees, just the other side. What the?
I heard you say we and I said G.
Weeeji.
Weeeji.
Weeeji. Is it spelled W-E space G?
W-E-E-G-E-E.
Yeah. That's like a rapper name.
Luigi.
Luigi. Your name sounds like Ouija, like the board.
Ouija board. That's why. Talk to Ouija using a Ouija board.
That's why he's so, like, in tune with ghosts.
There's a movie called fucking Ouija.
Is it Ouija or Ouija?
Ouija.
Ouija, that's right, yeah.
Yeah, so, I was thinking, like, you could... No, that can't work because that's too... That section's too long.
He said where there's no slant, so I'm guessing that means up here.
But the...
Nah, I hit the thing again. I guess if I just not hit that.
You're just gonna have to do it the hard way.
I could.
I feel like
you do it the normal way at any time.
Snowman's lost his head.
If we get low on lives, then I'll revert to that.
Alright. I think that was the second of the board game movies that Hasbro did.
After Jumanji?
No, Jumanji didn't exist. I'm talking about Battleship.
Oh, yeah.
Battleship was a fucking hilarious movie.
Does Ouija count as a board game, though?
I mean, it's not like it's supposed to be used legitimately.
How it's for entertainment.
Let's use a Ouija board.
I'll use it to I don't know. I was starting out as George Bush. Like, so they use it for important presidential decisions.
Spirits guide me!
Fuck! I hit the other wall this time.
That's how some avatars use to talk to their spirits is using a Ouija board.
Dad told me to do it.
I don't think George Bush ever said that. I wouldn't be surprised if he did, though.
Uh-oh. Okay. But we've had a lot of, like, phasing through things in this game.
Yeah. Just kind of, you know, random teleports. I would be surprised if something Mario was just flung to the side of the level.
Yeah.
This emulator's doing some...
Oh!
Wait! Oh!
Yeah, I gotta not hit the edge. Okay, last try.
Jump forward and hold your control stick the opposite way.
He's saying to jump forward, not backwards like I'm doing.
That's tomorrow, and that is it for us today.
What's tomorrow?
Nothing. I was thinking out loud. Mario just goes on a revenge rampage. He kills all of Bowser's bloodline.
I did it too early.
He also did it, like, to the wrong side.
No, he said to face away.
Oh.
But I had less success that way. I'm just gonna do it normally. I'm just running out of lives. I tried.
I mean, Mario, look at it from Bowser's perspective. Bowser has, like, a legitimate war, and he just, you know, kidnaps a POV. Well, not a POV,
POW.
Well, he has a POW in the form of Princess Peach, and they're expecting, like, her kingdom to capitulate, and then you got this random fuck dude just from Italy, just killing everybody, and then killing...
Oh, come on! You stupid body. Guess I'm trying again.
Eventually. Did you hit the slide and then
I just killed myself? Oh, no!
Oh, my God!
Well, that was cool for a
second
there.
That was impressive. Last life.
Yeah. I don't remember if this is a game that has that zero life or not.
The zero life.
Yeah.
The zeroth life.
They did that is that some games had the number representing your total number of lives and some representing your number of extra lives.
Donkey Kong was the latter.
Are you sure?
Yeah, because it... I remember because every time you lost a life, a balloon would pop.
I fucked up.
Ow.
Will it hit? No.
What was I gonna say?
You said Donkey Kong.
It would go down, and when it got to zero, you could continue playing, and then it'd pop again, and the number would just disappear, and that was it. That's how that went.
I still need to activate the cannon yet.
Probably should do that, yeah.
Can the thing come up, or do I maybe have to get it at it from down there? Damn it.
Just long jump down there.
Okay.
You can make, well...
I missed.
Bad
angle.
And...
Oh, nope, extra lives.
You should probably go deck... Okay, never mind.
Nah. Well, we'll be fine.
Yes, because you've got a great track record of keeping us alive so far.
Yep.
You need to rein in your arrogance there. It's unbecoming a Federation officer.
Oh, okay, there we go.
You think there are some people in, like, the Star Trek universe that are still, like, playing old school video games?
I'm sure.
I mean, they got the holodeck and shit. They can just live out whatever kind of real live-action roleplay shit they want to.
Oh, come on! I was right next to you.
I like the idea of somebody playing ancient old-school video games on, like, the Enterprise. Like, Super Mario 64.
Is that an Atari 2600?
I know, old-school...
It keeps me calm.
Dude, Klingons would love Call of Duty. Glorious combat! Okay, no. You know what game Worf would play?
What?
God of War.
Yeah.
Because Klingon mythology is all about how Klingons didn't like their gods, so they killed them all.
Oh, don't worry. We're seeing everything you're saying in the chat.
Yeah, you're good.
He thinks we're not looking at chat.
We are. We're just,
Okay, there. Cannon's done.
Ready for blast off! Whoa!
Okay, that's a thing. And poof. Nope.
Yeah, you... Thunderflop.
We gotta get to Sly Cooper.
Oh, we can. We will. We can actually run that without fear of frames dropping.
Yeah. I hope it's not just that it's like getting to be too much for the computer to stream as well. Oh, hopefully we can at least record fine.
We haven't had any problems with Smash, right?
No.
Then we're fine. As long as if we're doing PlayStation 2, we should be good. Uh-oh.
Yeah, I can't get around now. There we go.
Cool as ice.
Damn it. I've never had this much difficulty with this before. I swear, this never happens.
Gonna blame it on the emulator?
Yes.
That's convenient.
Whee! No fall damage. At least the bridge isn't icy.
Yeah, that would suck if it was.
Okay.
Now we're paying attention to you in chat. We're just we can kind of get lost in our own conversations.
Fine, he hasn't. We were following the instructions while we were happening, but we just decided to stop when we ran out of lives.
I were there to show. Oh.
I mean, we don't have the lives to do that special thing anymore, so.
Yeah, so we're just doing it the hard way. Yay, we got.
Just take
the star and fuck off. Hustle run, best run. 30 stars!
Yep.
We could actually unlock another door.
You recovered 30 power stars. Did you pound the two columns down?
No.
If you did, you'll have to stomp on the condor. Condor?
Condor.
They say that Bowser sneaked out of the sea and into the underground.
What? We haven't confronted him the first time! You're getting ahead of yourself, game!
Where's Bowser? I haven't fought Bowser!
Wall kicks will work.
Yep.
Last life.
This time I'm lazy. I'll take the elevator down.
This is all in your head, Luigi.
Alright, here we go. One shot, one life.
You got one chance. One shot, do not miss your chance to blow! You got it!
That wasn't that easier.
Well, if we you know, got good, we could totally do it the other way and be expert elite Mario players.
I'm good at other things.
I know.
I'm good at glitches. Just not that particular sequence breaking method.
We'll let you know if we need help, but we both played and beaten this game multiple times.
I know this game very, very well. You needn't worry.
We kind of sort of know what we're doing, we think. But you can just shimmy over. Just grab it, just...
Flying. Just the instant air brake of the power star.
You hit a power star, it's like hitting a net.
Yeah.
Is that it?
That's four levels. I mean, are we planning to stream something else after this?
I can't think of anything.
We have Budokai 2, but that's probably going to take an hour.
No, that will take an hour. We're already, like, 20
He's
minutes
going to
in.
Level 5.
Level 5. What's this level? Or are we just fighting Bowser?
I think level 5 is Booze.
Oh. You ready to fight some ghosts? If there's something strange in the neighborhood, who do you call?
Ghost Nappa!
That's right, Mario.
Whee!
Okay, you gotta show off the thing here.
Yeah, I'll show off the thing. Go on a ghost hunt. It is some legitimately haunting music on this level.
Yeah. Okay, you ready to do the thing?
I won't go for coins
show off the thing.
Until I have more of the levels available. Oh, it died anyway.
Oh, did you fuck up?
No. Oh, damn it. Now I fucked up. Get back down here.
Is it gonna produce a harsh sound?
No.
Oh.
That's not the glitch, but that does seem to be something that happens.
Face through. Apparently, you can't die by being squished in this game. Oh no! I'm trapped in the ceiling!
I have no head, I'm in the ceiling, and I'm apparently walking on water.
You're fine, though.
Yeah,
that doesn't crash the game, huh?
No, it doesn't crash the game. You just get your head stuck in the ceiling and you stay there.
I thought it would crash the game. Oh,
that was the glitch I discovered.
Fun glitch. Just...
And there's one that I would have showed you had we been able to get on top of the castle earlier, but I'll have to save that for when we actually have 120 stars. Oh, we don't have the second floor available yet.
We also don't have extra lives.
Yeah, also true.
Oh no!
Fuck off! Oh, I got hit.
You face tanked the book. Congratulations. You better get that red coin.
Come here, ghosts. Alright, I'll get the coin. Look, I'm so juicy in Italian. Come get some.
Pizza pasta force!
Come here.
Yeah, Xelrog here actually discovered it. The community didn't know that it existed until he discovered it.
This
apparently.
Was a while ago, though.
Long time ago.
The two games that I'm really knowledgeable about glitches are this one and Pokemon Red and Blue. Ghosts don't die!
I beg to differ. They apparently die really well.
All you have to do is punch him. It's actually really easy.
Yeah. Grow a tone!
I get it.
Fucking, they are, this is the Roanoke house!
There we go. Come here. Get over here. You're a ghost, you can go through things.
Come on, grow a tone!
Oh, he's staying behind like a pussy.
Get over!
Okay, fuck this. constant frame drops. Yeah, this is becoming an issue with our streams, and we haven't ascertained the source of it. But it might... We're debating if this might have to be our last stream for a little while.
Well, we'll have to go straight to YouTube. Skip the theaters. Just,
until we can upgrade to upgrade technology.
Yeah, the problem...
This is becoming a constant issue.
Problem is, we can't upgrade easily because we're both broke as shit.
Yeah. Alright, that's all of them.
You almost made a terrible mistake.
I thought I was going down to the merry-go-round. That's the second boss battle. Just the sound every boss in this game makes.
Oh no, YouTube.
Well, we upload all our streams to YouTube, so that's not new.
Yeah. You win!
And then the stairs don't come up. That'd be a dick move.
Oh, but I thought that was actually gonna happen. Here we go!
Literally memes. No, not live streams on YouTube. I mean just recording videos and putting them on YouTube. We wouldn't be able to stream at all if this keeps happening.
Yeah.
I've been meaning to, I still haven't gotten the chance to really try the new Awesomeoss matchmaking, so that's something that I need to do with, more in the game.
Yeah.
I have the chance.
I gotta stream some more Magic at some point, or
yeah,
play
Friday
some
Night Magic kind of fell through, didn't it?
Well, I had a new job, and I just kinda forgot about it.
Yeah.
I'll do Sunday Night Magic tonight, I guess, or something. I have the next 2 days off, so...
If you're interested, we're publishing, highlights of our Super Mario World playthrough a little later today.
Yeah.
And you can find the YouTube channel in the description on Twitch.
Same shameless self-promotion, because why not?
If he's interested.
Yeah.
That's up to him, though. Or her.
Do you assume that person's gender?
Triggered.
What was that? That was someone posted that about Marth on the Miiverse, right?
What? This,
you assume my gender?
Well, I don't assume. I know your gender, Marth. Wait.
Maybe you guys check out my channel as well.
Yeah. I check out everybody's channel. I'm subscribed. We're both subscribed to Vine Sauce, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and then I also am subscribed to Zuthar Pixel Cat.
Is that a streamer?
They troll Gmod.
Is that a yes?
Yeah, well, yeah, kind of.
Or just YouTube video.
Yes, and, who else?
Secret, the haunted books. Well, I guess I can, hundreds. Well, no.
Yeah, it doesn't take that long to just check out a video, I mean.
I think there's a second, ghost hunting star, so I'll wait until that one when I'm... Or 8 red coins, where I'm going to be getting coins anyway.
Ghost hunters.
No, fuck you guys. Ow.
Nope.
Aha, dodging.
Middle. Nope.
Damn it.
It's a good thing this doesn't, like... Get random.
Yeah. Oh, it just needed a punch, okay. Well, I could have done that at any time.
Secret of the bookshelf!
Punch it.
Regular, ordinary Swedish mealtime. Punch it!
I hear Bowser's moved on to this area. We haven't fought Bowser yet.
Bowser's moved on to this area!
Oh, well, I guess I don't have to go to the other one yet. Okay. Now 100 coins.
Bowser, top heel.
Top heel. Heart attack! Oh, I hit the wall. Oh, I don't have the invis cap yet.
No, you don't.
I really should have gotten that.
Where do you get that? You just kinda... Oh, the water. You can get that now. We still got tons of time.
Yeah, I could.
You're just gonna get the red
Well, actually, no, I have to beat Bowser before I can get that.
Well, that's not gonna take that long.
No.
It's the first one. It's the easiest one.
Come here. Remember when you couldn't touch these things, like, at all?
Well, Mario took a level in Badass.
Yeah.
He traded breath power for being able to punch ghosts.
Breath power?
Like, being able to, like, hold his breath very long.
Oh, yeah. Valuable trade-off. He realized the boos were getting to be out of hand.
Ghosts don't die.
Boozer?
Anywho, I would get Booster and the Reds in there.
I don't know who Boozer he's referring to.
Bowser, probably. I'm talking about Bowser. Though there is that Booster guy in Super Mario RPG. The one you still need to play.
Yeah,
I guess we'll do Thousand Year Door after we finish this game.
I guess. I mean, we could really start Thousand Year at any time. This one shouldn't take long, though.
This game, no. People will be able to speedrun it in, like, 3 hours.
I call Bowser Boozer, okay.
Because he drinks a lot. Drinks that cinnamon whiskey, that's how he's able to breathe fire. Bowser would be the kind of guy to just drink like, ale by the barrel.
Yeah.
Just attach, like, a handle to a barrel and just drink.
You just made me imagine Bowser with a Russian accent.
Comrade Mario!
I guess I should have done that when we were talking about John Wick earlier, though.
Communist Bowser. He wants to take down the monarchy and institute communism.
Get over it. You're a ghost, you can float! Oh, you bitch.
Just watch.
There we go. Okay.
Wait, what? What's, SMG4?
Slow-mo guys? Super Mario Galaxy? There's no Super Mario Galaxy 4.
Something. Super Mario something 4. Is it a flash? Is it like a sprite flash? I like watching those. I was the kind of guy to watch Sonic's Quest for Power and be all enthusiastic about it.
What was the big one? Super Mario Brothers Z? Was that a thing?
Yeah. I think that was maybe the same people who did Super Sonic's Quest for Power.
Yeah.
That one was hilarious. It was just like a lot of effects.
I'm pretty sure they did at least a section in Beat Up Sandbag too.
Yeah, they did. The random drowning pool song.
Oh, that's the name of a guy. He's a YouTuber.
Okay, cool.
Machinimas.
All right, cool. I'll find him.
Notice me, Senpai! Thank you.
Don't notice me, Senpai. Well, that's a game we gotta play, do one off of, is Yandere Simulator.
Yeah, it's gotten a lot of attention. Ow! That was weird.
You got coffin crushed. Hey, Scooby, we need you to kill all the ghosts in this mansion. No! Will you do it for a Scooby snack? Fuck you, bitch!
You trying to yeah. bribe me with food?
That's what a Scooby snack is weed.
Yeah.
I mean, it makes a lot more sense if you substitute Scooby snack for marijuana.
Yeah.
Because you wouldn't do... Just doing it for, like, a doggy treat, That's not something you'd be willing to do.
Hey, Scoob, you want to join me for a little bit of Scooby snack?
I'm surprised there is not a marijuana...
What?
I'm checking to see if there is a marijuana strain called Scooby snack.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Alright, let's go to Leafly.
Just... Four more coins. Is there another Boo here?
You better go back up to the underground.
Come here, Boo. No, I know where I can get some if there's not.
Outside.
Yeah, there's little spiders I can kill. Instant ear break.
Yes! Scooby Snacks! I knew it!
Well, you're gonna have to find that now, obviously.
Not immediately. I'm broke as shit, but...
Yeah.
Let's see. It's an indica-dominant hybrid that crosses Platinum Girl Scout cookies with Face-Off Uchi.
Are those both names of strains?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
I thought it meant like it actually had Girl Scout cookies mixed in.
No!
Be flavors! An interesting recipe.
Sweet, earthly, Puget flavor. Alright, that sounds... This strain is such an amazing sleep aid. It makes you feel like you are crawling into a grilled cheese bed of warm, gooey, cheesy sheets of goodness with toasted bread blankets.
Okay.
That's a great way to sell me on it, thank you. Then 9 hours later, you awake from what feels like hibernation, perfectly rested with zero haziness. I am all but non-functional within 20 minutes of smoking one bowl, so be prepared for bed when you enjoy some Scooby snacks. That's kind of the opposite as to what, like, Scooby, like... Because when he takes Scooby snacks, he's all energized
and
shit.
They're like his Popeye spinach.
It's more sativa than indica.
Yeah.
And this is just pure indica. That's weird.
Our viewer is now confused.
I smoke a lot of marijuana.
I do not partake. Jack does.
I do. Mainly for medical reasons. I've got a bad back, so it helps whenever it flares up.
Clearly.
Also, I do enjoy it for its intoxicating effects. I'm not a hypocrite.
Alright, Big Boo's balcony. The final fight.
What the fuck?
What?
This...
This guy's got some moves.
Yeah. Leg drop!
Yeah, brother!
Hulk Hogan.
Hulkamania's
running
wild.
Oh no, now you gotta actually do some climbing.
Okay, no. The difficulty here is the camera. Got it.
Resident Evil. Mario.
Oh good, I need that. Get over here.
Raccoon City sounds like fun!
Oh, you saw that bit.
Yeah.
Okay, and then the last one is the one I need the invisible cap for. So let's take out Bowser. Let's get some caps, and then that'll be the end of the video. Well, depending on how long Bowser takes.
Get some caps. Gotta drink some more Nuka-Cola.
Get it, Luigi.
I am all like
shrooms.
That is also a pretty big oversight that it can tell you about future Bowser levels when you haven't beaten the first one.
Well, I mean...
Oh no, it's not Peach at all!
What do you think this is, Undertale?
Okay, all right, there's Boozer. The big coin out there.
Boozer, you're a loser and a user. Bowser, if you do drugs, you go to hell.
You go to hell! You go to hell and you die!
Fuck with me, you go to hell before you die.
What was Russia's opinions on drugs? Do they have strong, like, drug bans or anything?
Oh, gosh. I think they criminalize all drug use.
Oh, stupid turn radius.
That's good, you got three lives. Well, two lives. Well, three
Mario
lives.
Mario doesn't have a turn radius, you say.
It's got... Okay. It doesn't have a significant turn radius.
Pretty fucking significant there.
So what you're saying is that this game needs faster turning.
Yes! All games need faster turning. There we go.
You know where I got that from?
I don't remember. Was that an RPG game?
Okay, so there's this guy, I think his name is Dark Id. He did a Let's Play of a game called Drakengard, which if I can track down a copy, we play at some point.
Supposed to be a terrible game, but
the story's amazing. So in this game, there's this it's basically Dynasty Warriors clone, and there's an item which enables faster turning, and Dark Id was like, faster turning? Oh yeah, it'll be useful in this breakneck style gameplay. He was appalled that would be a feature in this game.
Yeah.
And I'm just like... I was like thinking, okay, what game where faster turning would be useful? And I'm like, oh yeah, Spyro. That's a game that needs faster turning.
Yeah. Oh, Mr. SMG has come up with a Bowser catchphrase. Comrade Mario, let us fight like the badasses.
The Russian is on the case. Oh god, there's the Punisher movie, and then the Punisher took down this other guy, and then the main villain played by John Travolta is like, I want him dead! And he's like, call the Russian. I was watching that movie with my parents, and my parents were like, oh, the Russian! And then Frank Castle does battle with this giant muscular dude played by Kevin Nash called the Russian. Yeah. And he's wearing this like red and white striped shirt, and he just kicks Frank Castle's ass.
We call this guy the Bear Russian.
The Bear Jew!
Yes. I was adapting that, but for Russians.
Yes.
Bear Jew is better, though.
Bear Jew. Played by Eli Roth.
Russia versus Italy. I don't think Italy would have a very good time if we're going by, like, Italia-Italy.
Oh, God. Russia is...
Russia and Italia is scary.
Oh, totally. Was I looking up?
I don't know. More weed strains?
No. Hold on.
Fuck!
Well!
Camera,
that's okay,
why?
You got two more lives.
Gotta get all
those. Oh, you got three more lives. You got four more lives!
Lives
you
aren't an issue, I have to get the fucking coins again, though.
Unfortunately, there is no strain with Mario in it.
Yeah. That's okay, we were... It was glorious enough for us to see, go to a sushi place that had places that... meal dish names like Dragon Ball Z and Street Fighter 2.
Oh, wait, when did that happen?
When we were meeting up with the Ronimo guy.
Oh, the Mexican sushi,
yeah,
place.
Yeah, Mexican sushi.
That was awesome.
Combining Mexican and Japanese in ways never before thought possible.
You know, aside from the car crash that happened later that day, that was a pretty good day.
Pretty good day.
Yeah. You've since replaced that car with a similar model.
Yeah. I just, by sheer random chance, not seeking it out, the new car I found, or the new used car I found on, like, Carfax was the same make, model, and color of my old one. Just yes. A newer year.
Yeah. You can actually drive it with Uber in that one.
For a 1 year? Yeah.
For a year.
I was too impatient.
You got greedy. See, this is why I play a cautious style, so I avoid shit like that.
Heck.
Also, this emulator keeps the floor down.
The floor?
Yeah, you know, when you go in the first time and it just kinda, you know, the floor drops.
No, that always happened.
Huh. I don't remember it happening.
I do.
Okay.
Ask this guy, he's a Super Mario 64 expert.
Uber reaction?
Uber Italia. I don't. I got scared in the middle of that. I'm falling. Idea for a new Nario game.
Oh, go ahead. Super Narnia Brothers.
Is it a good Paper Mario game? Because I'd like that. I'd like that a lot.
I want a Paper Mario game, which actually plays like a Paper Mario game. Mario!
This is one random fuck platform of Goombas in the middle of the level. Like, Bowser thinks they're gonna do anything.
I'm surprised Bowser still uses Goombas.
Yeah.
Mario Virtual Reality. We had that on Virtual Boy.
Yeah. You know, the smash success.
There was only, what, 20 games made for that system?
If that. I know there was a Mario fighting game made for it.
Was there?
Yeah, you could play as, like, Toad and a Koopa. Including, like, actual Mario characters.
Like, a Mario game, platforming game, first person for the HTC Vive or Oculus Rift would be amazing.
Yeah.
I like how Nintendo... It was like the first one to do like an Oculus Rift type deal, but it was so archaic, and it was just too soon, and they never did it again, and then Oculus came around.
I'm willing to bet they're going to be the last on the Oculus train, on the VR train, now.
But I mean for the Switch. Oh!
Oh, the Nintendo Switch.
Virtual reality for the Nintendo Switch?
Does the Switch have, like, a virtual reality headset? Is that something they're doing?
I haven't heard about it.
If that is, that'd be sweet. That'd actually be a reason to get the Switch. Let me take a look.
I still think the Switch has plenty of potential to be a good system.
I'm not hating on the Switch or anything. I mean, it's an interesting design concept, but then again, that's Nintendo for you. They always do stuff non-standard.
I mean, what's different about it? It doesn't have anything special about it in performance. It's just saving you money because you don't have to buy two systems. That's the only thing.
Oh no. There's a story that the first story I see for when it comes to like the Nintendo Switch is bait and switch. Nintendo's new consoles, everything wrong with gaming hype.
Oh, okay.
That's not good.
Okay, is that straight from Reddit?
AMP, whoever the fuck they are.
You're weak.
That was quick. I look away for 1 second and Bowser's already defeated.
The Bowser in this game is a fucking disgrace. Like, they should have had 3 hits minimum for the first fight, not just the last.
He's trying to save his hit points.
It was just an idea. I don't know what he's talking about. The virtual reality Mario thing?
I know, I'm down for that. I love first-person Mario game.
It sounds like he thinks we don't like his idea.
No, I like your idea, dude. Don't be down on yourself. I like your idea.
Okay, let's get
I just don't think... virtual reality Mario game. I don't see anything about the Switch.
Okay, let's get the caps. Let's get those done.
Yeah, let's get those done and then finish. We'll finish that and then I don't know. I guess we'll call it. Let's see. Hybrid video... Type, hybrid video game console.
You want to take out Bowser twice in a row?
battle so nice, we did it twice.
So, Mario, what did you do when you got to the basement?
There was a basement?
Hardware. Comprising of Switch console, Switch dock, and the Joy-Con controllers.
You're slow, Rabbit!
We'll start to diminish production on the Wii U in anticipation of the Switch's release. That was quick.
I mean,
Wii U wasn't out for very long.
The Wii U was a commercial failure, despite, in my opinion, it being a plenty fine system with plenty good games on it.
Yeah. Well, they tried before, and ignored the fact that HTC Vive and Oculus are doing. I think they're doing well right now.
I think a lot of people are still waiting for the technology, though.
Well, they're waiting for good games for it.
Are they?
Maybe.
Didn't have to find a bucket or anything. Damn it.
I don't see... Unfortunately, I do not see... All right. What games do they have for Switch? Oh...
New Mario game was confirmed, I think.
Cube Life Island Survival HD. Constructor HD. Dragon Quest X. Dragon Quest XI.
Is that a Minecraft knockoff Cube Life?
I'm going down the list right now, so just give me a second. Dungeon of Czar.
Okay.
Just Dance 2017, of course. Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Monster Boy and the Cursed Kingdom.
I wonder how that's going to be affected, being able to be mobile.
Oh, they're making another Nobunaga's Ambition!
Okay.
That's been a long time since they made one of those! A Pokemon game.
Obviously.
Rise, Race the Future. A racing game. Open world game called Riverside.
You know,
I hope that's a River City Ransom game.
You know what's not on there?
What?
F-Zero. So sad.
Nintendo's a weird company.
Yeah.
They're eccentric now.
Well, shit, F-Zero GX, we can't top that. Might as well just never make another game again.
will never make another. No, I would love a I mean, if there's one thing that Mirror's Edge proved, it's that parkour games can do well.
Yeah.
Like first-person parkour games.
Oh, no!
Good effort.
A little slow. I remember when those were called platformers.
What? Well, I mean...
with realistic physics, I know what you mean.
Yeah, well, parkour is fun.
Yeah.
It's, oh, I mean... hardcore parkour.
I ain't stopping for anything.
Are you invincible?
No, I got the coin the same time I took damage.
Then the Mario series will die.
Because it's on the Switch?
No, because it's first person Mario.
Oh yeah.
We
talked about I think it was somewhere in the Mario World videos. We talked about what first-person Sonic would be like. That would be fucking nauseating.
Oh my god.
Can you imagine every time you jumped?
You'd have to recall the game.
Every time you jumped, all that spinning.
I imagine you wouldn't, like, they wouldn't show the camera view as constantly spinning. It'd just kind of be...
if you were first-person as Sonic.
Yeah. I'm honestly surprised that, like... oh. Keep in mind there's a delay between when you're hearing our responses to your questions and when we're actually seeing the questions.
Yeah, it was like 20 seconds.
If Nintendo stops making Mario games. They're never going to stop making Mario games.
Obviously. They've stopped making Paper Mario games, but that's different.
Yeah. They got Mario Party, Mario Platformers, remakes of Mario games, Super Mario Ouija...
Super Mario Ouija board. Fuck! Okay.
Man, all they
fuck! Need to... fuck! Mario, they need... jump!
All they need to do is make a gritty Mario game. You know... give that to me.
You wanna take over?
I'll take over. Alright, where's the intro to the... where do you go to, over here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Show us how much attention you've been paying.
Okay, I'm playing now, by the way.
Yeah, this is Jack.
Yep, down there.
Man, 60s isn't that old. Don't be talking about Miyamoto dying on that.
Oh,
that's
no,
a,
don't do that! Miyamoto is a legend! When he dies, it's gonna be a fucking national tragedy for both Japan and America!
I only recently discovered those puppet bits they did at E3 for Nintendo. Those are pretty awesome.
I didn't know they did puppet bits. Was it like Kermit and shit?
Didn't I show them to you?
You might have, and I forgot.
Yeah, it was Satoru Iwata, Miyamoto, and the guy who's the American CEO.
The late, great Satoru Iwata.
Yeah.
Oh, you're talking about Reggie Fils Aimée.
Yeah, him.
Yeah, he's cool. The first time I saw Reggie Fils Aimée was when he was during the Nintendo Wii, like E3, and
yeah.
He was talking about how at Nintendo they love kicking butt. I'm like, yeah, you go, guy.
Yeah.
Alright. It was a total tragedy when Iwata died. The fan art on Xelrog was through the roof.
They did a Did You Know Gaming on Iwata.
Yeah.
That I think was actually pretty recent. That guy was a hard fucking worker. He did like marathon runs just working on games.
Yeah.
When no one else could complete them. Everyone else said, that's impossible. He was the Giacomo of Nintendo.
Follow your heart, and you can...
I want a backflip here.
Yeah. Well, no, I'm good. Oh, okay. Second attempt. Yeah, got it!
You don't exit the level when you hit that, right?
No, you don't. You
okay.
Just kill yourself. Yeah!
The intended way to exit this level is to kill yourself. That's reassuring. Makes Mario disappear. What are you looking at?
I'm looking at the chat.
Yeah.
And, they should do another, like, just Luigi game.
That doesn't necessarily have to be about ghosts.
Like, the only two Luigi games are Mario is Missing, which sucks, and Luigi's Mansion, which is alright. It's actually an alright game.
There's also...
Here you go.
There's also Luigi Brothers U.
I'm so glad I showed you up right now.
I loosened it for you.
That doesn't work with video games, pal. Xelrog's playing it again, by the
way. Yeah, that's back to me. I'm gonna get the metal one to get it out of the way, and then we're done.
I feel so bad for Luigi.
Yeah.
Just because he's like, his existence is just is practically a fucking fluke.
Well, and Smash Brothers, and he's been adapted. He finally gets his own character development, and his character development is that he's a coward.
You know what my favorite like canon for Luigi is?
What?
You might want to go back to the ghost to finish that level. Oh wait, you don't need the invisible cap for that one, do you?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
I guess we could do that.
No, my favorite headcanon for Luigi is that he's just rich. He doesn't need to go on adventures because he's just this rich fuck.
Well, yeah, that's our headcanon, is it? He's got the real money. He's got a mansion and everything.
Okay, let's put it in perspective. Mario, like, 100 coins for Mario is like a challenge. You collect 100 coins.
Yeah.
But Luigi, in like one run, collects like 1,000 coins, and that's just the tip of the fucking iceberg.
Yeah.
Like, it goes up to like the millions. Not the millions, the billions. Luigi knows how to make money.
Yeah. He's the entrepreneur of the brothers.
Yes.
That's why he's not off chasing princesses who don't actually care about him.
Oh, God. That's the real irony, is that Mario gets all the fame, but he gets cuckolded by Bowser, and he might be a deaf mute, idiot savant, if you will. Oh, fuck this stage. I don't like this at all.
Just Peach and Bowser hanging out in Bowser's castle.
Oh, look, he's coming for me again!
Oh.
That's so cute!
So am I, princess!
No, it's like Peach and Bowser are you know, they're an item.
They're fuck buddies. They might actually love
him. And Mario thinks he's saving her, they're just toying with him.
Mario NTR out.
Yes. I was waiting for that thing to come over so I'd get its coins, but I guess that's not happening.
Oh, no.
Fucking swoopers. I always thought they were parrots in Mario World. Because they were green, and had like red beaks.
I guess Luigi is lucky, and he might have the good luck because of the L.
Yeah, sure, that's it.
L for luck.
Okay, this isn't the way.
Here, just get the coins to heal!
Yeah, I guess I should.
Also, there's a star there. You might as well just grab it.
I guess.
I mean, you're gonna start from the very beginning anyway, so fuck it.
Oh. No, I go back to the maze.
Oh yeah, that's right. You're just wanting to get the cap. The cap. Yeah, Mario.
We'll come back another day in another video.
Luigi's the smart one. He knows how to pick his battles. I wonder who the father of Mario and Luigi was. What color he wore and what his letter was.
Maybe it was Wario.
Vincent? Vincione?
Giovanni?
G. Yeah, he wears a G. And what's his color? Purple?
That's
no, that's
Waluigi.
Fuck
off, Mole.
I got it! Black.
Yeah.
And it's like, Mario was the favorite. And he treated Luigi as like the runt of the litter.
Yeah.
Mario has bad fucking luck because he can't even get 100 coins without falling and even dying.
Okay, I think it's over here.
I guess comparison, despite the fact that Luigi doesn't have any fame, he still has the greatest revenge of living well.
Yeah.
Who needs respect when you got a shit ton of cash?
Can you imagine Luigi doing a gangster rap album?
Oh god. That's what I was thinking of! Like, Luigi just bragging about how much, like, fucking cash he has. It's a hard dog life. For L, it's a hard
epic
dog.
Rap battle, Luigi v. Mario. Oh, come on!
They did do the Mario Brother one. So there's three in the tunnel.
Apparently.
Navigating the toxic maze.
You know what? We'll get the metal cap next time.
Yeah, just finish the ghost one.
Yeah, I'll get the ghost star.
Ooh.
People fucking love him because he's the underdog. He's the working man out on the adventure.
Yeah, the underdog. Not like Luigi, ultra successful. Everybody hates him because he managed to...
He's a businessman. He's the big corporations that everyone's out against.
I think he manages Mario's talent.
Yeah, sure.
Like, he pretends to be second fiddle, but really he's like the microchip to Mario's Frank Castle.
Yeah, sure.
Or the... I don't know. Who else is like a good manager character for a hero?
I was just thinking of, like, Jade and Jackie Chan.
Luigi's the Jade to Mario's Jackie Chan.
Except Jade actually goes on the adventures.
Well, Luigi does, occasionally.
Yeah. He did it in Mario RPG. And he did it in, Super Paper Mario, which... Did you ever play any of that, or was it just me?
I played some of it. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I played some of it.
Yeah.
I played, like, to the first boss, and that was it. I remember because it was... You were in another,
Luigi is the Donald Trump in the Mario universe.
No, because Luigi does fucking insult women.
Yeah. Minus all the you know, the hate.
Yeah. People don't hate Luigi. He's just not as popular as Mario.
Luigi is the Steve Jobs of the Mario universe.
No, Steve Jobs is pretty hated, bro.
Is he?
A little bit. Oh, hey, Jock.
Come here, you big eyeball. Wow, that was easy.
That was too easy. This was too easy.
I just had to go to the attic. Well, I guess that's it. We beat the big eyeball.
Yeah, that was easy.
Almost more of a challenge than Bowser. The big boos were more of a challenge than Bowser. Nice try, asshole. Okay, that's our Mario stream.
Wait. What was he saying? Was...
Daisies. His girl is queen of fucking Daisy.
Yeah, that's, you know, it's worse. It's not like Queen of Peach or Queen of Toadstools, but, you know... She had nice, dark skin. That was kind of exotic.
Alright. So, we're done with Mario. I don't know. Do you still want to try continuing with the streaming after this? And
it wasn't that bad. I mean, we only 5% of the video's gone forever.
Yeah.
And the stuttering is... I don't know. We could try just doing just recording and see if that changes. Like a test, like 10 minutes to see if...
Yeah. What? Okay.
Oh, he's sleepy. Oh, he's going to sleep.
I feel like a creep now.
We're watching you sleep. we're watching Mario sleep.
I forget how long you have to wait before he starts talking.
He just talked. Now he's asleep.
No, he talks after he slept for a while, like he sleep talks.
Fuck Daisy. Oh yeah, I want to.
I've played Mario Strikers.
Oh god, everybody had attitude in Mario Strikers!
Everyone had asses in Mario Strikers.
Oh god, even Mario.
Ooh, wears short shorts.
Do you have Mario Strikers?
We can nope.
Play? Oh damn, I had it at one point. We could have totally played it if I remember to keep it.
So this stream has degenerated into watching Mario sleep as we talk about Daisy's ass.
Let's just end it.
Alright. See you next time, guys.
See you next time.